Hi guys! So today, I thought I'd show you what Rwandan money looks like. I always find the images on money interesting because they show the places and people that a country feels most proud of. So without further ado, let's jump in. Rwandan banknotes come in 500, 1,000, 2,000 and 5,000 franc denominations that range from green to pink. This is useful if you're new to the country because it acts as a warning system. The more red in the banknote, the higher the denomination. At the moment, the Rwandan franc is about 1 to 1,000 with the American dollar, so 5,000 francs is around $5, 2,000 francs is around $2, and so on. The smallest note is Maganatanu, 500. It says National Bank of Rwanda along the top, and Iinoti Yemewe Namategeko below, which means this note is legal tender. The image is of Igishekisheki, which is the treetop canopy walk in Nyungwe Forest. Nyungwe National Park claims to be the furthest source of the Nile, and it's home to 13 species of primate. The canopy walk is a major tourist attraction. On the back, we have the same information in English, and a picture representing the One Child, One Laptop program. In 2008, Rwanda participated in the OLPC program to provide every primary school child with a laptop in the hopes of improving the quality of education and fostering an early interest in technology. I'm not sure if this program is still running, as OLPC disbanded around 2014, but it was a huge initiative at the time, and last year Rwanda announced a continuation of the project with one laptop per teacher. The next note is blue, Igihumbi, 1,000. On one side, we've got the golden monkeys, which you can go and see in Volcanoes National Park. On the other side, we have a traditional Intori dancer in gold, dancing above the ethnographic museum at Hue. So Hue, formerly Butare, is the main university town in Rwanda, about 3 hours south of Kigali. This is a large museum with geological, historical and cultural exhibits. Next up is the purple note, Bibiri, 2000. So this one's caused a bit of debate. I don't actually know what this image represents. At first, I thought it was maybe a landmark that I didn't know about, so I asked a few of my friends, and no one was able to say where it is. We kind of came to the conclusion that maybe it broadly represents technology and Rwanda's technological aspirations. The Rwandan Space Agency was founded in 2021 and expects to launch its first satellite by the end of 2023, so technology and communications feature high on the list of national priorities. But if anybody knows exactly what this is, please drop it in the comments below. Above is a little golden Agaseke basket. The Agaseke basket is very traditional to Rwanda. They're also called peace baskets. They're often used to give gifts at weddings and special occasions. On the other side, we have coffee. Alongside tea, this is one of Rwanda's biggest exports, earning around $66 million in 2020. Last, we've got the biggest note, Bitanu, 5,000. Again, we see the Agaseke peace basket centre stage. And on the back, we have a silverback roaming Volcanoes National Park. Mountain gorillas are Rwanda's biggest tourism draw. Along with DRC and Uganda, it's one of the only three countries in the world where you can see this endangered species. So it makes sense that it's featured on the biggest banknote. Now, there are some coins in Rwanda, but most people never use anything smaller than Ijana, 100. On the front, it just says 100 francs. And on the back is the national emblem of Rwanda, again, an Agaseke basket. This symbol is also the watermark on all of the banknotes. It's always handy to carry a few spare 100 franc coins, as you might need them when paying a moto driver or at the shops. Next is a 50 cents piece. Again, it's got the national emblem, and on the other side is corn or maize, which is a popular snack, often roasted over an open fire. The last few coins are hardly ever seen in circulation nowadays, but they are 20 cents, 10 cents, 5 cents, and 1 cent. I have a 5 cent piece, but it's very grubby, so I'll use these nice images instead. Now, I'm going to have to take a guess here, because I'm not absolutely sure what a couple of these are. So if you know, please drop a comment below. I'm most uncertain about the 20 cents piece. I'm going to guess that might be eucalyptus. It's not native to Rwanda, but it grows everywhere because it makes good firewood and it's very fast growing. The tea estates plant large eucalyptus forests and use the wood to fuel the tea drying stations. That's what these leaves look like to me. Now, the back of the 10 cents is obviously bananas, but it's bananas in bloom, because this long protrusion here is a banana flower. And yes, they do look that suggestive in real life. So the 5 cent coin has got me stumped. The leaves of this plant feel like they look familiar, but I can't quite place it. There are several sacred plants in Rwanda, so I thought maybe it was something like the Umuko tree, which features in the legend of the hero Rwaingombe, and is believed to protect houses, like the Rowan tree in the UK. But it doesn't look quite right. Perhaps it's a fig of some sort. If you know, drop it in the comments. Finally, here's the 1 cent coin. I don't think I have ever seen one of these in circulation, but the back looks like sorghum, which is a type of millet used to make traditional beer. So, that's what Rwandan money looks like. Let me know what your favourite image was. Fun fact! Some of the notes for this video were a bit crumpled, so I ironed them to straighten them out. Then I thought I'd include a UK £5 note for comparison. And it melted. Yep, that's right, people. In 2016, the UK started to switch from paper money to plastic money. And now it melts if it gets too hot. So here's a US dollar instead. I know nothing about American money, so I had to go and look this up. But this is apparently George Washington, the first president of the United States. Dollars are a very different shape to most other banknotes, in that they're quite long and thin. On the other side, we have the bald eagle, which is the national bird of America. And then we have this weird Masonic-looking emblem with a Latin inscription that reads, Annuit Coptis, he favours our undertaking. I think they're referring to God. And Novus Ordo Seclorum, New Order of the Ages, and the date 1776, which is when America gained independence from Britain. So that apparently refers to the founding of America ushering in a new age. There's a really interesting section on the design on Wikipedia that goes into much more depth. So there we go. If you've enjoyed this or you've learnt something new, give it a like and consider subscribing.